From 41 Sieber Way, welcome to the home of the New York Mets. This is Citi Field. We're going to be treated to a gorgeous day for baseball on the show. The Atlanta Braves going up against the New York Mets. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So just about set now. Now in for the Braves, Eddie Rosario. The pitch. Now he breaks his bat. And he beats the throw. He's safe.
Hey, whatever works, right? Doesn't have to be impressive. He actually kind of fooled him with the breaking ball on the inside part of the plate there. Didn't get a good piece of it, but he got just enough to fight it off and make it work out.
Ozzie Albies takes one off the outside here at the belt and fires. Just missed. Well, who would have thought Jacob DeGrom as a college shortstop and then a ninth round pick by the Mets was going to turn into this good of a pitcher? Back-to-back Cy Youngs in both 2018 and 2019. Next pitch misses, and now 3-1. Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two.
Yeah, Boog, just incredible. You look at that benchmark of 200 innings, comfortably over that in 2018 with 217. And the sub-2 ERA, just impressive at 1.70 to lead the league.
Matt Olson up to the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And the 1-0. Just off the inside edge.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Oh, now this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way. Gone. Matt Olson goes deep. And now they're out in front. It's 3-0. Here's Marcelo Zuna. That includes the left fielder, number 20. First offering misses the mark.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Next pitch is outside.
He hasn't wanted to challenge him. Both of those pitches off the plate away. Don't expect anything down the heart of the plate. You may just have to be patient and take your walk here.
Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Now around second, going for third. And he's got himself a triple.
Back-to-back base hits. Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Here's Austin Riley. This one blasted deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. Austin Riley goes deep. And they throw a pair on the board. It's 5-0. Adam Duvall at the plate. Batting six. The center fielder, in there for strike one.
With how good these offenses are, there's a lot of ball game left.
Next one is off the plate, and it's a ball and a strike.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Next pitch inside. Now two balls and a strike. And now 2-2. Next pitch inside, and a full count now.
You see how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings. Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Dansby Swanson stands in. Over to McNeil. Over to Alonso. Double play. Two outs, bases empty. Now it's Alex Dickerson.
You know, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
Next offering is in for a strike.
That was absolute gas. Triple digits on the gun. It's just a different experience as a hitter watching that go by.
The next offering misses. Gonna count 1-2. Left-hand batter waits. Bounced out to short. Sends it to first. That'll end the inning after a lot of scoring. We go to the bottom of the first, and stepping in for New York, Brandon Nimmo.
Leading up for the Mets, the center fielder, Brandon.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. To the right side. Got him on the off-balance throw. One up, one down. Here's Starling Marte.
The right fielder, Starling.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Ball one there. The wind of the pitch. And down on strikes. Two up, two down. And now it's Frankie Lindor, a switch hitter batting right.
Francisco Lindor.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. And he deals. In there for a strike at the top of the zone. The lefty ready and a 1-1. That one fouled off. Fly ball down the line. Rosario moving to his left. Makes the grab on the run. And that is that. Top of the second. And now it's Travis d'Arnaud at the plate.
Leading off for the Braves, the catcher, Travis.
The pitch. And strike one to the catcher.
Bringing the cheese on that one.
And the 0-1. And there's a curve through for a strike. Singy wasn't very sharp in the first. Got hit around a little bit. Just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff in the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, but he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location. Sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Left-hand hitter waits. And ball one. Singy, he wasn't real sharp in the first. Got hit around, but really more so. Didn't throw a ton of strikes.
Well, he's just got to find a way to settle down. He was clearly fighting himself out there, not really finding the strike zone, walking batters. So we'll see if he can get back on track and fill up the zone a little bit more.
Next offering is way upstairs. The why to kick the pitch. Ground ball, Alonso. He'll do it himself. Two up, two down in the top of the second.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
And look out as that one ran in and got him. So now to the plate for Atlanta. Matt Olson. He's already homered in this one. Next offering is down low, and that's ball one. DeGrom checks the runner. Albies dives back in. Hey. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, I've noticed they've been pitching him hard inside, and the key is if you're going to make a mistake, you've got to make it off the dish. If it leaks out over the plate with this kind of power, you'll be asking for a new baseball.
Two outs. Strike two.
The count is one and two.
And the righty deals. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Bottom half of inning number two. And stepping in for New York, Pete Alonso. And the pitch.
Alonso.
That one called a strike. And that is strike one. Next pitch has popped up. Hauls it in, and there's one away. Here's Mark Canna. And first offering is fouled off. Just off the outside part of the plate. Next pitch is outside. Turned on, but foul wide of third. And now the lefty. And now the count filled up 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Pretty good spot on the outside, but just couldn't quite clip the zone. That's a stone cold take.
Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to it. First pitch, and he just misses. And here it comes. Ball. Looked like it was a little bit up.
Two balls, no strike.
2-0. That one misses. That's five straight.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
The pitch. Downstairs, and it misses ball four. Now it's J.D. Davis. Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. J.D. Davis goes deep, and they throw three on the board. It's 5-3. Base is empty, one away. Jeff McNeil stands in. Good contact guy, good defender. Next pitch downstairs, ball one. Kicks and fires. And there's a ball. Ripped on a line. Pulls it in on the run. That's out number two. Now the catcher up to hit, James McCann.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. The pitch. Up the middle. And a base hit right there. And that extends the inning.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. Smash that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
Nimmo at the plate for the second time as he takes ball one. Here comes a pitch. That one misses. Now 2-0.
Two balls, no strike.
And a pitch. now 3-0.
I got 3-0.
And a pitch. That just missed. He walked him on four pitches.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
Marte batting for the second time, and that's strike one. Kicks and deals. In the dirt. Over to third, but the throw's offline. Two outs, two in scoring position. Next pitch in the dirt. Two and two. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The 2-2. Back to the mound. And it gets by him. Throw in holds that trail runner at third base. They're at the corners with two away.
His confidence level is so high. Really nice job of coming through in a big spot. Good extension on that swing. Took the pitch on the outside part of the plate and drove it up the middle. He let it travel just enough.
Lindor in the box now. Takes strike one. 0-1 now. Upstairs.
I got a ball, one strike.
That one ran inside, almost got him.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Lefty out of the stretch. Runners at first and third. Stays alive. Runners on first and third. Two away. And that one sliced foul. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Freed throws to first. And he's back safely. Oh, and he hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, he's kind of backed himself into a corner, and I'm sure starting to feel the pressure right now. We'll see if he can bear down and get out of this one. These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
All loaded up, dangerous hitter at the plate. That one missed.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count, base is loaded. You don't want to fall to a three ball count and then walk in a run. He's got to challenge the hitter right here.
And a pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. The pitch. Check swing. Now we'll look down to first. Yes, he did. Down he goes on strikes.
Hotline blinging, hotline ringing. Why they keep calling me? I don't judge, but you fake. Case closed, and I ain't got a law degree. Can't understand why they all on me. I'm crazy. Don't get involved with me. I drop the top and feel this autumn breeze. You need gas till we can be all on.
DeGrom back to work. Ozuna in now. Takes ball one off the plate. The wind of the pitch. That misses off the outside edge.
Two balls, no strike.
The wind to kick the 2-0. And that one missing low.
Count 3-0.
Check swing, but he went too far. 3-1. Righty delivers.
fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Riding to the plate. Stays alive. The punch out there. Leadoff man retired here in the third. Here's the third baseman, Austin Riley. He's one for one with a two-run homer his first time up. Foul ball there. And he deals. Now 1-1. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. And that is a foul ball. Tap dances out of the way of that one. 2-2 down. This one popped up right side. Alonso under it. Makes the grab. 2 down.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
And next for Atlanta, Adam Duvall worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. First offering, and it just misses. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's the strike. 2 down, nobody on. And that one a little bit high.
He really committed to that fastball up at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, it gets hit hard by a power guy like this. That's a nice miss right there.
Next pitch is inside. And now 3-1. 2 outs. And now it's filled up.
3-2.
The wind to kick the pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Got a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Swanson in the box now as he looks at ball one. Second plate appearance of the day for him. And the pitch. Curveball drops in there. At the belt and fires. That one ripped. He's got it. And that is out number 3. As we go to the last of the third, and stepping in for New York, Mark Canna. A wind and a pitch.
Canna.
It's been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning is so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
Hit in the air, right field. Rosario makes the grab. One away. Eduardo Escobar now at the plate. First offering misses the mark. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Drops into the glove. Out number 2. Now it's J.D. Davis.
Now back. The designated hitter. I don't wear J.D. Davis.
Slapped foul. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
And he chases that one. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Yeah. Back here at Citi Field, and now the DH, Alex Dickerson.
The designated hitter, Alex Dickerson.
And here it comes. That misses the zone. 1-0. Left-hand batter waits. And a count 1-2. And the right-hander deals. Missed inside with the curve. 2-2 now. Swings and misses, and that's the first out. Now in for the Braves, Travis Darno struck out swinging his first time. Fouled off, he was late. Yoan.
1-1.
Popped up. McNeil under it. And there's two away. Here's Eddie Rosario, 1-2.
Eddie Rosario.
Foul ball. Next one misses, 1-1. And the righty deals. And that one upstairs.
I got 2-1 the count.
Ball just three. Missed.
Count is 3-1.
The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball. And that's ball four.
Gosh, another walk in this one. Man, he is having some real issues with control.
Ozzie Albies up to the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Good eye right there.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even. Kicks and fires. Popped up right side. Alonso under it. And that is that. Back here in Queens, ready to go, bottom four. And now here's Jeff McNeil.
Second base.
And a pitch. In there at the knees. Strike one.
Well, he hasn't quite settled in out there. 4 runs in 3 innings. He's going to have some quick 1-2-3 innings to pitch deep into this ballgame.
Base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dot.
Now, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
James McCann in now. In there, and it's 0-1. Pitch.
Ball one.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
Next pitch misses way outside. And now the lefty outside corner got him looking. He can't believe it. Back to the top of the Mets order. Next to hit, Brandon Nimmo. He's 0-1. And that one wrapped foul.
This guy absolutely flies. The defense wants to turn two, but they've got to get a ball they can do it with. Make sure you get the first out before you try to rush and get two and end up with nothing.
The 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here comes a pitch.
I got to count 1-2.
And now it's even up.
They tried to get him to go, chase the pitch down and away, but he wouldn't bite.
Kicks and deals. Stays alive. The 2-2. And fouled off. Off balance feed. There's one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice. Starling Marte up to him.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
Next pitch is outside. And that misses upstairs. Now 3-0. And a pitch. There's a strike. That's strike one. And he couldn't come up with it.
Well, that's a pretty significant two-out walk as it moves the tying run up into scoring position. It's definitely not what you're looking for from your pitchers late in the ballgame. If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
0-2 now.
Rarely will you see a pitcher just waste a pitch like that. The batter wasn't even tempted to swing. Every pitch needs to have a purpose so that it can set up a following pitch to help you get that out.
Next offering way off the plate. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Ground ball, base knock. Heading for the plate. Here comes the throw. But it's offline. He will score. It's 5-5.
Big RBI for him right there. I know that was a ground ball, but it was absolutely hammered through the infield. That's not one you're excited to get in front of if you're an infielder. You know they used to say, charge it. Crazy.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. And the pitch. And here's a slow roller. Tosses across to first. Gets him easily. Ends the inning. Ready now for the fifth inning. And here is Matt Olson.
Well, Boog, after watching the first inning of this one, you would not have expected that this pitcher would be in such a groove and still in the ballgame at this point.
First offering misses badly for ball one.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
And 1-2.
The count is 1-2.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And one away. So now it's the four-hole hitter, Marcell Ozuna. 1-for-2 in the game. He tripled and scored in the first. And that one fouled off. Next pitch is inside, and a count even, 1-1. And a swing and a miss at the slider in the dirt.
Not sure what's going on right there. No chance. Probably have some funny texts from his buddies after the game.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And the first two set down at the top of the fifth. Two outs, bases empty. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Austin Riley. First pitch, and he just misses. Right-hander kicks, deals. So two balls and no strikes. Just missed. Here's a 3-0. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Well, he's starting to look a little gassed to me, and we'll see if they go to the bullpen in this spot or not.
Adam Duvall next up for the Braves.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
The pitch. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
More and more guys are looking to slug regardless of the count. In this situation, we'll keep a close eye on his approach.
0-2 now. And now 1-2. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs.
Here in the fifth inning, and here he is about to throw his 100th pitch. Man, he's really had to grind through to get to this point.
Got him, and that'll do it. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the left fielder, Mark Canna. The pitch. And he pumps it a strike.
Well, in an 0-0 count, not every strike is a good strike for a hitter. I like the plate discipline there.
Next offering misses, and now it's even, 1-1. And he deals. And that one hammered. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track. Eduardo Escobar up now for the Mets. And that's in there for strike one. The pitch. Swing and a miss. A wind of the pitch. Stays alive. The 0-2. Ground ball up the middle. And it gets by him. One down, runner at first. And next is the designated hitter, J.D. Davis. He's already homered here in this one. Meanwhile, this pitch gets away. The tag, and he's out at second. The lefty, the 1-0. On the ground to third. Riley fires to first, and that will end the inning. And they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Seth Lugo. And he has some nasty breaking stuff. Lugo. Top of the sixth inning. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Dansby Swanson. The pitch. Not even close there. And that's ball one. And a big swing and a miss.
One and two.
The 1-2. Line drive. Base hit. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. I'm amazed at his ability to pull his hands inside and actually square that baseball off. That pitch was off the plate. So tough to get the barrel to anything in there.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. He sends it out of here, and they lead it. It's 7-5. Travis Darno, next up for the Braves.
Up next for a play, the catcher, Travis.
And first offering is fouled off. Just off the inside edge. The 1-1. Tries to hold up, appeal to first, and he went around. Ruled a swing. 1-2 now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. This to center field. And that's a base hit. So now back to the top of the order.
No, he didn't get much of that one, but it's going to look like a line drive in the box score tomorrow. These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop out, and it just...
Swing, and this is ripped down the right field line. Way back there. Out of here. A two-run shot, and they tack on to their lead. It's 9-5. Drew Smith gets the ball now. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit.
The batter number one, second baseman, Ozzie Albies.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Righty delivers. There's a strike. And a 1-1. Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone. Ozzie Albies goes yard, and they tack one on the board. It's 10-5. And now Matt Olson up to hit. That one's in there, 0-1. At the belt and fires. And a foul ball. Down to the dirt, swing and a miss. McCann fires to first. Got him. One away on the strikeout. Stepping in, Marcelo Zuna. 1-for-3. In there for strike one.
0-1.
And a swing and a miss there.
Quickly in an 0-2 count, you've got to figure out a way to shorten your path to the baseball. Put it in play somewhere, then you got a chance.
Next pitch off the play, and the count is 1-2. Right-handed reliever. This one popped up. Lindor pulls that one down, 2 down. And next for Atlanta, Austin Riley.
Austin Riley.
out towards left center. Canna makes the catch, and that'll do it. Tyler Matzik will take over on the mound, and he's got a nice lead to work with.
Number 68, Tyler Matzik.
And welcome back. And now, Jeff McNeil.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
There's a strike. Matzik, known as a guy with pretty lights out type stuff, racks up the strikeouts, but the command at times can elude it. The next pitch misses, and the count is 1-1.
Yeah, and a manager in a situation like this, this type of pitcher has to stay alert and ready. He's got to make sure he's watching from pitch to pitch, hitter to hitter, to quickly get another reliever up in the bullpen if he needs to bring someone in.
Swanson right there to make the grab. One up, one down. McCann up to hit for the third time as he lays off inside, ball one. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul.
Clearly he was geared up for the fastball right there. Maybe got a little jumpy and excited out of the hand, but he certainly didn't miss a stitch.
Next pitch misses, and that's ball two. And that lack of command, that's usually one of the things that leads guys to be converted from starter to reliever.
Yeah, and it's such a short stint when you compare the two roles, starting and relieving. You hope that guy can find strike one right away when he comes in.
One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss. Now 3-2. And a pitch. Got him looking. And now two gone. Here's Brandon Nimmo. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
All one's the count.
Left-hand hitter waits. So now 1-2.
Two strikes.
Left-hand batter waits. And that one fouled off. Next pitch is popped up. Riley makes the catch, and that'll do it. Back here at the ballpark, top of inning number 7, and now Adam Duvall.
The center fielder, number 14, Adam Duvall.
Smith back to work, and that's outside. And that one is lifted in the air. Marte pulls it down, and there's one down. So digging in, Dansby Swanson.
Swanson, former first-round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff, but really coming into his own.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. And the righty deals. Good eye right there.
I got the count 1-2.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Two out. Here's Dickerson down. He's already homered in this game. First pitch just misses. Righty to the plate. And downstairs. Swings and misses at the pitch off the plate. Two outs. Fought off foul. Here's the 2-2. And another ball. This one lifted in the air, left field. Canna makes the catch, and that'll do it. Welcome back. Set for the last half of the seventh. And stepping in for New York, Starling Marte.
The right fielder, Starling Marte.
And the pitch. And ball one to the right fielder. Swings through that one for strike two.
One and two.
And now the lefty just missing there. Two balls, two strikes.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Next one just misses. And the count is filled up. And here it comes. That one pushed foul. Foul ball there. Three, two. And it's fouled away. And a payoff pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches. Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
So a man aboard, Francisco Lindor, up now for the Mets. First pitch, not close.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
Breaking ball inside. Two balls, no strikes. And a pitch. Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. And a pitch. There's a strike, and the count is 3-1. There's a strike.
3-2.
Kicks and deals. He swings and fouls one off. Stays alive. The pitch. Foul ball. Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
3-2 now. Ground ball left side, could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. They get the double play and just one out to go now. Now here's Darren O'Day to take over for the Braves. Right-hander who throws from the side, really almost down under. And he'll try to keep this big lead right where it is. Here's Pete Alonso. First offering misses the mark. Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-1.
Wow, no fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move till the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just kind of have to tip your cap on that pitch.
The next offering misses. And the count is even, 2-2. Down to their final strike. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
When you hit five balls out of the yard, you expect to win. Some teams live and die by the long ball. Today, these five homers, they really led them to victory.
And your final, 10-5. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
Subwoofer bouncing like a trampoline. Glass shape when I roll past the scene. Candy apple paint dripping classic green. Everybody eating, you can ask the team. Fast and mean, speakers bumping, tags is clean. Keep me something to f*** on, bad to poke on. Bass hit like an earthquake. Just hold on, I hit the block and roll on.
Got like 218s. Our favorite Too Short song is in those jeans. Shake it, baby.
Score for our ball game this afternoon for the victorious Atlanta Braves. 10 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 4 men on base. For the Mets, 5 runs, 6 hits. No errors. They left 5 men on base. God don't like the time of the ball game, 4 hours and 18 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely. Run, better run. Mama told me never fold, run, better run. Like Jenny told Forrest Gump, run, better run. The race for freedom ain't won, run, better run. Had to make it out the red clay, run, better run. West side of Atlanta, yeah, that's where I'm from. Outside, our hands on like a glove. Moving like Magadori, eating on the run. Still an underground king, and that's worth it, bun. Locked in like Rice Creek without a bun. I was playing with the powder way before LeBron. My wife was born a redhead, but now she a blonde. Politicians lie, and your favorite rapper is a con. Don't check for me without a check for me, that's a hun. All the L's I wear is followed by my tongue. Get money and the power, teach them while they're young. Blessed to make it out the slum, run, better run.